Hi, this is Paul Mulvey. Welcome to the first series of Breaking Bad Requirements. If you've been going through withdrawal, that the series is over. Welcome back to a new one talking about requirements and bad requirements and how to break them. So first one up is why I have a $500 recipe machine. Why is that? Well, let's look at what led to this, okay? So business problem. I have two daughters at home. No, they're not the problem. I also have a wife at home. She's definitely not the problem. Or could I even make any mention that she could be the problem, okay? She might be watching this. The problem was the MacBook laptop between them. As the girls were going through school and they were getting older, they had to do more and more projects on laptop computers. So we had two in the house, one that my wife and the girls shared, and one was mine because I never learned how to share with other people, but actually I took it all over the country and traveled with it. So they had to learn to share this thing, and it was getting very, very tough. You know, my wife could use it during the day, the girls would fight over it coming home, so she says, I want a new MacBook. I'm like, that can't fit into our budget. Along comes the iPad, right? Steve Jobs, brilliant. So my wife says, hey, the iPad, this is great. I can get my email, I can surf the internet. It was awesome. She also said, bonus, $499. So I'm like, yeah, I see the $499. I think this is a great solution to the problem, right? We'll buy her an iPad. So we go about getting the requirements for the iPad. We say, how much, you know, songs and storage do you need? Well, it turns out she had like almost nothing that she stored on the laptop. 16 gig was just fine for her. The other one is she doesn't travel around anywhere, so she didn't need the wireless. She didn't need the 3G or 4G. Well, at the time it was 3G. She didn't need any of that, so get the Wi-Fi. Done. So we bought it. Then we bring it home, and after a week, that keyboard. I just can't type things on the keyboard. I keep making mistakes. It keeps auto-correcting my stuff. So we went out and bought a physical keyboard, right? Not too bad. Now she can type. But when she leaned that iPad up against something, it was slippery on the back. It was slipped down. So now we needed a case that had kind of like a rubber traction to it. Well, the case just didn't stand up at the proper angle. So we went out and got this little loop thing, which kind of made it look like it was a laptop at that laptop-ish angle. So we've got that one. Then she needed to write documents. Well, yeah, she could use Google Docs, but it wasn't user-friendly for her, so we bought her a word processing app, so it looked similar to what she was used to with Microsoft Word and whatever. Then she needed to print stuff out. Well, she couldn't hook up with the cable to our current inkjet printer. We had to buy a brand new printer because the iPad only goes Wi-Fi and only a certain type of Wi-Fi, so we had to get a brand new printer so she could print things out. Finally, the last thing that happened, oh yes, it gets better. Excel. She needed to share and distribute Excel files, not numbers files, but Excel files. So what we had missed really was the fact that the iPad is a consumption machine, not a creation machine. So end game, we had to buy her the laptop because of things that she needed to do. By not really understanding the whole mission or the essence of what she needed to do in the beginning, we went down the road of the solution, which was the iPad. Now, there's kind of a happy ending to this because I got the iPad and I got my $500 Epicurious recipe machine. So, what to do next? Why don't you go out to EnfocusSolutions.com, look at other great ways to solve some requirements problems. Follow our Twitter feed at Enfocus Solution, mine at Paul the BA, and I look forward to the next video where we can talk more about breaking bad requirements.